The views are out of this world.
This thing is unbelievable. It sounds incredible.
Golly gee, everybody, look at that.
Welcome to South Australia. It's been a while since our last visit, so to make up for it, we're giving you two amazing drives back to back. To kick it all off, we're not too far away from the CBD, and a lot of this drive will be through the magnificent Adelaide Hills. Now, besides my crew, I'm pretty much going this alone, which is quite a shame, seeing as though I have a 7-seat SUV and somewhere with room to sleep. Before we hit the road, let me show you what I'm talking about. This is the Mitsubishi Outlander, and the one I'll be driving is a plug-in hybrid. This is the Exceed Tourer, which sits at the top of the Outlander range. It gets a bunch of standard features, including a panoramic sunroof, memory front seats with massage function, front and rear seat heating, Bose premium sound system, pull-up rear side sun blinds, and two-tone exterior paint, just to name a few. It's a great family proposition and a great car for a road trip. It's got 7 seats, is refined, comfortable, and has great features on the inside. It also has towing capabilities, which works out perfectly because we got this from our friends at New Age. It's got plenty of tricks up its sleeve, and it might even save us on a night's accommodation.
This trip kicks off at Windy Point Lookout in Belair, just 15 minutes outside the city. There are plenty of towns to explore on the way to our final destination. So we plan on heading through the hills to Mount Barker, Strathalbyn, and we'll finish at a popular campground in Kupito. Of course, there'll be a stop for a fun activity along the way. As mentioned, we picked up a camper from New Age in Adelaide. As always when towing, don't forget to do your checks. Is the tow hitch attached correctly? Have you checked your indicators and brake lights? Safety comes first, so put aside some time to ensure that everything is as it should be before you hit the road.
Drive through the beautiful Adelaide Hills and stunning regions. These are areas that I've always wanted to visit. The drive all up is under 2 hours. Of course, we're going to take longer to tackle it, and there are lots of beautiful towns to stop in on. But the good thing to know is that you can do this in a day. And we're doing it all in an SUV, which, if you didn't know already, was crowned the 2023 Drive Car of the Year Best Medium Hybrid SUV. So I've tested it before. I know exactly what to expect, but this time round, I'm towing. So yes, I'm going to be very safe. I'm not going to push myself. I'm certainly a lot more aware of my surroundings, still getting used to looking in my rearview mirror and not seeing road behind me. But I do have quite a lot of hilly roads to conquer ahead of me. I just hope that I'm not that person that holds up a massive line of traffic. The Mitsubishi Outlander PHEV, straight up, it gets points for all of the standard amenities in here, and that includes seat heating. Even though I'm a Melbourne girl, I never get used to this cold weather, and I'll let you know it is the middle of winter and it's absolutely freezing. Fun fact, Mitsubishi Outlander, it's really fitting for this season actually, because it's all about adventure. And the nameplate, the intention is that when you're driving this car, you should have the feeling of journeying to unexplored lands in search of adventure. So we're not really going to unexplored lands. We're not too far away from the CBD, but we are certainly going to be exploring, and I don't think we'll come out disappointed. I'm in the town of Strathalbyn, which is a must-see on your travels. It's just 60 kilometres southeast of the CBD, is the gateway to the Fluro Peninsula, and is also known to be one of the most beautiful towns, not just in South Australia, but in the country. It's surrounded by rolling hills, tall gums and farmland. And once you're walking through the streets, it's rich in culture and there's lots to see, including great eateries. It's a go-to for antiques and collectibles, and it's got an abundance of heritage listed buildings, some of which date back to 1939 and are still in use today.
Don't go past this place though. This is Gilberts Motor Museum, located on High Street. And if you're a car enthusiast like me, don't be in any rush, because this museum is packed with incredible classics, muscle cars, merchandise, collectibles, everything you could possibly imagine and more. And that includes a dedicated Formula One room. Most of these items came from the Formula One Grand Prix that were held in Adelaide. And guess who sponsored the very first in 1985? Good find. This is Glenn Dix, a South Australian motorsport legend. He spent decades officiating in speedway, motocross, karting, circuit car, and bike racing. He's best known for his flamboyant flag waving on the finish line of the Adelaide Formula One Grand Prix, and a lot of his fascinating collection can be found right here. This place is made possible with the efforts of volunteers and supportive sponsors. So if you're passing through, be sure to stop in and say hi. I almost forgot that I was on a schedule. As I've already mentioned, this is a BEV, so it's obviously going to be a lot more efficient than its petrol counterpart. Mitsubishi have been the pioneers in the plug-in hybrid space for quite some time. The Outlander PHEV is in its second generation. Under the skin, it's got a 2.4-litre four-cylinder petrol engine paired to two electric motors, combined power of 185 kilowatts and 450 newton-metres. Look, the power is fine, it gets off the line well, but I would like a little bit more power, especially with all of the ascents that I've been tackling. It gives that really angry rev noise. One good thing though, there are other modes that you can choose depending on whether or not you want to be charging your battery. I think for a car like this one, in terms of power, it gets the job done, and you're not really expecting an SUV like this to have blistering power outputs. What I will say is that the steering is great. It's really refined. I mean, we've been going over a lot of harsh surfaces, a lot of speed humps, and besides for feeling that pod moving around a little bit, it's actually performed really well. .5 litres per 100 kilometres is the claimed fuel consumption, which we know that we're not going to reach. We are towing, we've got a lot of weight behind us, and that puts strains on a lot of elements in the car. So yes, we are going to expect that number to increase quite a bit on this trip, but at least I'm not going to be looking at that gauge and worried about my fuel consumption. Another must-see in this region is Mount Barker, the largest town in the Adelaide Hills with a charming main street. It's surrounded by vineyards and mixed farming. And while you're there, visit the numerous heritage buildings, the local Laratinga wetlands, and take in the vista at the Mount Barker Summit Lookout.
I'm standing in a timeless dream of light mists, of pale amber rose. Feels like I'm lost in a deep cloud of heavenly scent, touching, discovering you.
We put a lot of research into trips like these, but I have to say, I really wasn't worried about what the driving roads were going to look like. It's not like I had to zoom into Street View and check them out, because we are in beautiful regions in Adelaide, especially the Adelaide Hills. One of the best parts about this trip is that first you get a bit of a warm up to the main event, and that main event is the drive along Gorge Road, up and down. It's absolutely stunning. You've got rock walls on one side and then beautiful views over stunning Adelaide Hills. There's sweeping bends, your twists, your turns. It's everything that I want for a drive, especially through the Adelaide Hills. It's better than what I was expecting. Thankfully, I didn't hold up too much traffic, and there's only really one freeway stint on the route that we're taking. There are other routes that you can choose, but it's over and done with pretty quickly. Quite a bit of traffic though in Adelaide, which has been surprising, but I have to say that this goes down as one of my favourite trips so far. Unfortunately, we're already nearing the end of our journey, and the last place that we're about to visit screams adventure. And then after that, we're going to be parking up for the night. Apparently, I'm going to be sleeping in that pod. Look, it's 9 degrees outside, 4 degrees expected overnight. So while the intention is there, let's see if I actually end up executing the plan.
I mentioned earlier that we'd include an adventure stop. Well, here it is. This is Tree Climb, located in the Kupito Forest, 50 minutes south of Adelaide, in the Mount Lofty Ranges. I guess I've put the Outlander through its paces, so now it's my turn.
Harrison, perfect location for it in the Kupito Forest. Tell me exactly what I'm going to be tackling today.
So today you're going to head up, you're going to go through our four courses. So we sort of start off with different difficulties. We go easy, medium, hard, then a zipline course to finish off with. So we start off a little bit lower, which is nice. So our first course on the grand course is the same as the kids. And then we work up in height as we get more difficult, end up at about 10, 11 metres off the ground.
Well, look, I'm seeing kids up there and they're doing a pretty good job. So it'd be embarrassing if I don't do well and get through it. Any tips before I get up there? Because I've got a camera watching me and I really don't want to embarrass myself.
Don't look down, just look at the obstacles.
Don't look down, okay.
We've done a lot in a day. Time to park her up, and we found a very popular camp and picnic site set in the natural eucalypt woodland. It's located within the Kupito Forest, known as Chookarloo Campground. If you're wanting to use a campsite for a day's visit, then you're required to book and pay for the site online prior to arrival. This camper has everything I need, including a cozy bed, but one item will no doubt make the crew very happy in the morning.
It's early in the morning, it's freezing cold outside, the crew's hungry, so welcome to Cooking with Emma. I'm going to take you on a real culinary journey. some first-class dining for breakfast this morning, and that includes eggs and bacon on toast. But this is pretty cool. If you don't have one of these and you have a Mitsubishi Outlander, then this has a trick up its sleeve too.
That's right. This SUV offers two AC outlets, one in the second row and the other in the cargo area, capable of delivering 1500 watts to power home appliances, just what we needed to complete our five-star breakfast.
Breakfast.
Much as you blame yourself, you can't be blamed for the way that you feel. Had no example of a love that was even remotely real. How can you understand something that you never had? Oh baby, if you let me, I can help you out with all of that.
So what did I enjoy the most about driving this car? Well, firstly, it is so comfortable. These seats are almost like sports seats. They really hug you. It's a great ride, really refined, and it's got good steering. I would say, though, that I would have liked a better turning circle. I did get in a few situations where I was trying to turn around. Of course, you need more space when you're towing, but it did manage to get the job done. Other than that, it's been a really great drive. We hope you enjoyed it. I certainly did. And I felt really confident behind the wheel of this car. If you're needing a 7-seat SUV, something that's fuel efficient, practical, and has great styling as well, then this might just be a car for you. One of my favourite drives yet. Great towns, really friendly people, and I think having this SUV along with the camper was the icing on the cake. But note to self, I think the next time I decide to sleep in a camper, it'll certainly be during summer.
I had a dream. I got everything I wanted. Not what you think.
We started this drive at Windy Point Lookout, not too far from the CBD. It's then a windy run through the hills. We stopped at Mount Barker, Strathalbyn, tackled the course at Tree Climb in Kupito, and finished this journey with a wholesome breakfast at Chookarloo Campground. Next week on the show, we're still in South Australia and in an SUV. This time though, we take a Jeep Grand Cherokee to one of the greatest wine regions in Australia. That's next week on Drive.